But today, this webinar is how to achieve robust PCB design workflow for signal integrity. A little bit about me, my name is Tim Wang Li, and I'm from Keysight Technologies. My background is in signal integrity. Right now, I'm a PhD candidate in University of Colorado in Boulder, learning a lot more about simulation and measurement correlation. And I'm almost done with my degree, and I just can't wait to for COVID to finish and for my PhD degree to finish. Now, before I do anything else, I want to answer the question, how to achieve robust PCB design workflow. Well, there are three things. First, you have to understand the possible root causes of signal integrity issues, what we'll cover in the presentation. And second, you want to make sure you use the electronic design automation, EDA tool software, to create some kind of prototype, a virtual prototype that you can play with. Then finally, you want to rely on a dependable manufacturer for layout, fabrication, and assembly, and that will be Sierra Circuits. So here is a workflow in a simplified form. First, you have the early design phase, you have the PCB layout phase, then you have the PCB fabrication phase. Now, in the first part, you know, basically you have system block diagrams, schematics, things like that. Going into the PCB layout in the middle, you start specifying your stack up and your layout design. Finally, you go to the PCB fabrication where a manufacturing and assembly are done. Now, with Keysight can really help you with our software ADS is, you know, the early design part. With Sierra Circuits, of course, and the PCB fabrication. But now the worlds are emerging. Our software is slowly creeping into the PCB layout. Not as good as the other layout tools, but it's also Sierra Circuits is taking its place into the PCB layout and simulation place. Now in the middle, we have this virtual prototype, which is very powerful that can help you troubleshoot and understand your channel more. Now, how does that look like? Let me introduce you to engineer Tread and his traditional design approach. He has usually a design based on vendor guidance and fabricate prototype and measure the performance. That's a traditional approach where if I give it a score, it's a very practical, I have a 5 at practicality. Effort, low effort because you are basing it on a existing design. It's kind of hard to troubleshoot and it's kind of hard to do the what if analysis. And here is a summary. It's easy to fabricate, but you need experience to know where to look for problems. And it's really difficult to perform the what-if analysis. A second is engineer Rob and his robust design approach, which we're introducing today, is you create a virtual design prototype. You simulate and validate your prototype. You fabricate the prototype. And finally, you measure and you verify the performance. What this does to us is, it's still very practical, it's at a 5. Effort is a little higher, but what we get out for putting a little more time is its ability to get you to troubleshoot and to do what if analysis. The punchline here is that you invest a little more time, but you get a lot in return. You see the score here, the troubleshooting score is too higher than the old traditional approach. And the ability to do what-if analysis in your robust design workflow with a virtual prototype is 5 times better. So that's why we need to focus on this new and robust design approach. Now, if you have any questions right now, you can put it in chat. I'm monitoring the chat. If not, we're gonna move on to the approach. So today we're gonna cover all the way from understanding the signal integrity issues, the rule of thumbs, estimations, to creating a virtual prototype into the layout and 3D extraction. So we'll do that last. And then analysis, come back to the virtual prototype. That is the what if analysis and troubleshooting cycle here. In the process, we'll look at eye diagrams, mixed mode S parameters, TDR, and single pulse response. And all with all this, it's very important to anticipate before you simulate. It's very easy to just press the simulate button or to look at a measurement. But as engineers, we need to know what we're gonna see before we simulate or before we measure it. That's the other thing that is going to be important today is anticipate before we perform a simulation or a measurement.